Alvin.
The final contestant in the elimination challenge is Alvin.
Alvin is amazing. So intelligent. He knows so much about food. I really think Alvin's going to be in the top five.
Inside the beignet is coffee with chicory brewed pretty strong, mixed with sodium alginate, and that's set to cool, and that's dropped into a calcium chloride bath, which sets a gel around the sauce.
What is that?
It's the coffee sauce, Chef.
It's extraordinarily bitter. There's like a coffee blood clot.
I think the resting time may have set more of the alginate base than I would have liked.
It's not because it's been sitting, it's the fact that it was wrong before it even got put in there. At my restaurant, we use some of these techniques, you know? But we never go around and try to trumpet that we're using it because it works and it speaks for itself. But things like this give what I personally do day in and day out a bad name. Whether it's got a cool ingredient or a technique or not, that's just bad food.
It's weird.
Disgusting.
Max, let's go.
When I present my dish, I'm really proud. I like the presentation, and I think the judges are gonna find it genius.
What in the hell is that?
It's about 15 crepes.
15 crepes?
Stacked together.
15 crepes in there?
About that much.
Okay, in between the 15 crepes, what is it?
It's a mixture of cream cheese, mascarpone, some espresso, a little cream, some sugar.
Damn.
You have to do this with me. You have to taste that. It's like I've just gone to the doctor's for a skin graft on my butt.
Yeah.
And stuck it in caramel.
Yeah.
That is a horrible, weird texture. That's rancid.
That good, huh?
Wow. You know, the fact that it's an elimination test, it's serious. There's no sweetness. I don't get a lot of coffee flavor at all. I don't get much of anything aside from the weird texture. I would be worried, actually, with what you made here.
I have a fully crusted peppercorn, creamy rosemary, garlic mashed with a béarnaise sauce.
You normally put béarnaise sauce on your steak?
French.
Not many French people I know, but does the consistency look nice? You like the thickness of it?
I would have liked them a little thicker.
Thicker than that? What's in here?
Shallots, rosemary, and garlic.
And flour?
I had a little bit of starch because it was
raw?
Liquidy.
There's raw flour in here.
What?
That is a severe technical error to serve raw flour.
There are several things that you can never do in cooking, and adding flour to a liquid mashed potato is one of them.
I was praying that someone else's dish was worse than mine, but adding flour to mashed potatoes like that without cooking them down is a big no-no. Even if someone's dish was worse than mine, I still have a really good chance of going home.
There was one individual who got tripped up. The lack of protein, no meat, no fish, put that person into obscurity. And that dish belongs to Christian. It wasn't cohesive, it wasn't properly thought through, and the whole sort of style of the dish was strange.
We didn't expect it from you. It was really something subpar. We were very disappointed.
I think you're wrong. I don't think my dish is the worst dish here.
Esther's dish looked pretty.
Think what you want.
Well, you have the right to disagree, but we're telling you the way we see it, and we thought the dish sucked.
Christian is acting like a little punk right now. His arrogance, it's stinking up this kitchen.
He has no filter. You don't argue with Gordon Ramsay.
I don't agree with you.
Well, we're trying to give you constructive criticism. If you're a man, you'll take it on the chin.
It comes from here to here with zero filter.
Unfortunately, your talent's not matching your arrogance. The dish was a letdown. End of story.
All right, Angel, come on down, please.
This looks like a mess. A hot, heaping pile of mess.
You look angry. What happened?
French got the best of me.
What is it?
It was supposed to be a custard to go inside my tart, but...
Where's the tart?
Back there. It didn't do well.
Obviously, the tart speaks for itself, so I don't know what else to say. Sorry, Angel.
Okay.
I already know it's a disaster.
Yeah, no, you're not wrong. It's like the kind of dessert that'll give you for a month. I'm more embarrassed for you, because I think deep down inside, you can do a lot better. Jennifer, let's go. Right. Yeah, what is that?
It's a Pennsylvania Dutch play. It's pork and sauerkraut.
What the hell were you thinking?
It's what I grew up with, so...
So if it's that what you grew up with, then this should be mind-blowing. You don't look like you've achieved much.
All together, you have, it's all to meant to go together.
Disgusting. Because that is a joke. Not impressed. And I think one of your weakest performances in this competition. You know that at least one of you is leaving MasterChef tonight.
Understood.
I just look at that and it looks like a pig on my bowl. I'm gonna stop there. Sorry, that's a joke.
This is a great example of what garbage is. If you're gonna serve us crap like that, then you're really wasting our time. And you guys, think about what we're here to do at this point in the competition. Jennifer, that is really disappointing. You were on a great trajectory, and I don't know where that leaves you, quite frankly.
Okay, Aaron, let's go. Holy.
My gratin didn't work, my steak burnt. I had to make the vegetables in the last 5 minutes.
What have you done?
I had a bad day.
So where's a part of the $500 truffle?
I made a truffle butter that I basted the vegetables in. I had to put something on the plate.
Come on.
My gratin didn't work.
You had an hour. I am speechless.
So, is there anything you're happy with in this dish?
Nope.
Nothing?
Nothing.
You're in the PR biz. How would you sell this? How would you put a spin on it?
I wouldn't.
All right, I'm not selling it.
I've been saved before on bad dishes, but it would have to take a really, really, really bad dish for them to top my bad dish.
Okay, Susie, let's go.
Her dish looks like a baby.
What is that?
It's just a glazed pork belly, a braised cabbage, and spätzle, as well as a gravy.
Mmm. Mmm.
What?
What's the spice in there?
I had cloves in there. Okay.
One word for that. Quite possibly the worst sauce I've ever tasted in my entire life. It's bits of chewed up dog bits of crap stuck together with, you know, soft bits of spatula at the bottom. And there's revolting in terms of the raw spice and the sort of horrible, bitter taste. Be careful.
This show is called MasterChef, not Delusional Chef. What do you know about German sauces and German cuisine? This is a freaking disaster. I will not even be able to taste the dishes that I taste after this because of you. It is awful. And if it doesn't send you home, it probably should. Go back to sleep. Ugh. Ugh. Horrible.
If Adrian's plan was to knock me out of the competition, congratulations, you just did it.
Jennifer! Your dish definitely stood out. Unfortunately, for all the wrong reasons.
Jennifer, this I have to make a point of, because this is not even about cooking, about technique. This is a complete disaster. This lamb is raw, is completely raw. You can't... You take this thing and you cut it in half, it would be dangerous to serve a piece of lamb like this to a judge. This is raw, raw. Do you see this?
Yeah.
Raw. What are you thinking about trying to serve us raw food? We're here to judge this thing. We're watching you cook. We're not idiots. You know, if it were for me, this is not an elimination round. I would send you home now. This is a serious cooking competition with a serious prize. Don't come in here and waste our time, because it will throw you out of this competition if you do something as stupid as to serve us raw, unsanitary food.
I didn't trust my instinct. And tried to plate a bigger plate than I really wanted to. I should have stuck with just the chops. And I don't like looking like a fool. And it sucks.
Alejandro, next, please come up.
So I marinated the loin with some cumin and cayenne pepper. I made a apricot and marsala sauce. And I made a sauteed kale with roasted pine nuts.
Right, so you go... Uh-oh. It's raw. Is this raw?
I didn't realize.
How are we gonna taste this?
We can't taste that.
I just feel like, oh no.
What happened? Did you look at it before you put it on the plate?
I guess I didn't see the other side, sir.
It's raw.
Yeah, I trusted the thermometer and I
didn't
look at it.
Trust your eyes.
You put on the plate.
Yeah, if you put it on a plate, it doesn't matter what the temperature is.
I don't know, guys. See what we want to make of it.
I can't really find anything nice to say about this. You know, it's just completely, you know, unforgivable.
Truthfully, you've had the easiest cut. You must have seen it.
I served this side, sir, and I...
Okay, my name's Gordon. Sir, both sides are pink. That is raw. I just look at that, and I look at what you've done in this competition, and it's like, we've gone back to your fifth grade. We're down to the final nine, not 90. And I think of the Muppets and the idiots we had to sit through for days on end, on a stool, eating from redneck sushi to this. I don't expect this.
I'm thinking like, man, I'm going home today.